Welcome back to the Ed Schultz Show. I'm Mike Papantonio, sitting in for Ed, talking about the insanity that's overcome politics and the gun issue. Got John Nichols with me. Doesn't need an introduction. John, I think your reaction is probably is the same as mine. It's time for leaders to lead now.
Well, I'm just old enough, Pap, to remember when I was a little boy and Bobby Kennedy was assassinated in June of 1968 at the Ambassador Hotel in Los Angeles. And if you remember the immediate aftermath of that assassination, there was, of course, the appropriate national horror, as we should feel about Aurora as well. But in very, very short order, within days, Congress was called into special session to address gun issues because the President of the United States, Democrats and Republicans said, when something as horrific as that assassination occurred, we had to assess, we had to, you know, stop and think, are there things that we can do? Certainly nobody, no one suggested scrapping the Second Amendment. No one suggested taking away the right to hunt, the right to protect yourself, any of that. But 40 years ago, 45 years ago, our response to a national tragedy was, we are a great big country that can handle great big issues, and we can sort these things out. Today, unfortunately, our response is, no, we're afraid. We're afraid that a group like the National Rifle Association, which is really in many ways a conduit for all sorts of corporate money. It doesn't even, you know, it's not really, you know, using just the dues of gun owners. It's this part of a broad corporate network that defines our politics is so scary that Democrats and Republicans kind of run to their corners rather than act as leaders.
And then rather than deconstructing, you see, if I had young lawyers working with me, who were incapable of deconstructing a lie, they would be in this firm a week. If I said to that young lawyer, how do you deconstruct this lie? The lie being that it is the NRA. I mean, all the NRA is a monkey machine. It's a conduit. It's a front for things like Arsenal Incorporated, Benelli, Beretta USA Corporation, McMillan Group. You know, all of these. There's 12 companies, for example, that manufacture assault weapons.
Right.
They're Arsenal Incorporated. They're the same people who order. They order the NRA. What to say? They say, this is what you must say. You are our trained monkey.
Now,
to deconstruct the argument is say,
hunters,
no, hell no.
Gun owners, you represent us.
Yes.
That's the key.
Yes. You don't represent the guy that wants to go goose hunting or deer hunting. You don't even represent the guy who might be afraid to, you know, he wants to have some protection around his house. His shotgun does it. A 9mm Glock. I've got something called a judge. If you don't think it, it's a 45 caliber alternate slugs and 45 caliber shells. I mean, my God, if I'm so paranoid that I can't protect my home with that, I can't protect the office with that. Well, I need counseling, man.
Well, and this is the thing. Look, I'm like you, or maybe not like you exactly, but I grew up in rural Midwest. I was 7 years old. I was holding my grandpa's guns when he was skeet shooting, you know, and I was taught gun safety as a child. I mean, I made bullets in my grandpa's basement made shells. And so, you know, those of us who grew up with this, who've been around guns, we're not afraid of them. We respect them. We understand their power, their use in a sporting context and in a self-protection. But we can have reasonable discussions about this. And one thing where I'll potentially correct you a little, Mike, you know, when you talk about the NRA as a conduit, as a front for these big weapons manufacturers, you make the presumption that the money flowing into the NRA is only coming from those folks, right? The fact of the matter is the NRA has been in the forefront of opposing disclosure of where money comes from in politics. Mm-hmm. They've actually scored votes on disclosure. And my fear, my contention is that the reason they do that is because they have made themselves a conduit, not merely for weapons manufacturers, but for all sorts of corporations that may not even have anything to do with gun ownership or gun production. They become a political player with a limitless amount of political money that they can flow into campaigns, and that has a huge influence.
Well, the last debate on disclosure, if you recall, they threatened legislators.
Yeah.
And they said, if you vote for a bill that forces us, that forces disclosure under Citizens United, forces to tell the public where the money actually comes from, then we'll mount a secret campaign against you.
Yes, and we will rate you as anti. We will suggest to hunters in rural Florida or rural Georgia or rural Wisconsin that you're anti-hunting.
Okay, now think about
it. Because you're in favor of disclosing where money comes from.
John, think about this. If legislators had enough courage, if they could find a spine, if they could find a backbone, if 50 of them said, okay, bring it on.
Yep.
Do this with 50 of us. Let's see who's going to stand. They don't have any courage. They can't even unite around something as simple as this. They're the same people that had the hell beat out of them growing up by bullies who wanted their damn lunch money. They don't have courage. If 50 or 60 of them got together and said, you know what, NRA, I'm tired of your talk. I'm tired of your smack talk. You're telling me that you want me to vote against a bill that discloses and tells the American public where the secret money comes from. And if I don't do that, you're going to punish me with a secret campaign. Come on, let's get our 60 legislators together. Come on, see if you can do that to 60 of us.
Well, and let's take this one more step. Let's do this right. Let's think of who might do this. Let's say that Tom Coburn from Oklahoma, who's actually shown a measure of independence, and maybe a John McCain, if you get his act back together. And then also take, somebody like a Dianne Feinstein, who's very safe politically. Take a group of these folks and have them step up and say, Democrats and Republicans, liberals.
Say, I dare you. That's what
they
need to say.
To go a step further, though. Let them say, if the NRA does this to any of our colleagues, we will come as a group to defend that.
Right. But that's the point, John. You know what to do. Mm-hmm. I know what to do. People listening to this program know what to do. But the people within the Beltway are so Beltway dead. Hell, you can't even hear a commentator suggesting what we're talking about. Tune into mainstream media today. See if a commentator will even talk about the obvious, and that is there is strength in number. If 50 or 60 of them got together and did exactly what you just said, NRA would be over. This blood money that's killing our children would be history. We wouldn't have toddlers laying dead at the on the floor of a movie theater.
And Pap, let's take it that final step. Let us say the truth that this is not a gun issue. This is a money and politics issue. We, the people, we are not a dysfunctional country. We could settle these issues, protecting our Second Amendment rights, protecting hunter rights, protecting people's ability to preserve their safety, and yet putting reasonable controls so you can't buy a 100-round automatic weapon.
To go hunt deer, a high-capacity 100-round magazine because I want to hunt deer, or because I'm so damn afraid, I'm so crazy, I'm so nuts that I have to have it in my home because I think the gangsters are going to sneak up on me in the night. I mean, that's what it is. It's either fear, or you simply understand that, the whole idea of preserving the Second Amendment is a lie. It's a lie. That we're past that argument. When you have people dead in a theater, when you can't say to your child, okay, darling, go have fun, go see a movie, everything's going to be okay, go buy some popcorn, see you later tonight. When you can't do that in your household, it's because the damn NRA and a bunch of thug manufacturers, armaments manufacturers, have control over legislators who have no guts.
Tell Ed what you think. In 140 characters or less, follow Ed on Twitter at WeGotEd.